Good morning. Welcome to today's seminar about renewable energies. My name is Ricardo Horta Asensio. I'm a process engineer and I have 20 years of experience in the oil and gas industry. Before going in detail on today's topic, integration of renewable energies in oil and gas and petrochemical business, I want to talk about two obstacles I have seen all this time that avoid to take further actions and to implement this kind of measure. The first one is the idea that there should be some kind of technology and only one which should cover all the needs in terms of electricity, heat and coal demands of the industry, which means we want to replicate the potential of natural gas to generate electricity and heat. That means we want to replace the fossil combustibles by not changing anything. Considering the increase on global average temperatures, the impact of global warming, we are already facing a problem we have to solve. We have to take advantage of all available technologies and squeeze their potential to reduce the greenhouse gases emissions. Every single joule we produce without CO2 emissions will count. The second point, my second concern, is the idea that society changes will lead us to a world free of hydrocarbon. No need to do anything, as market itself will make our world carbon free. This moment will arrive for sure, but not now and not soon. Trends, so we still want to use our cars to travel abroad as much as we can, to enjoy our lives, to use plastics and other substances coming from the oil. This is fair. Habits will take time to change. Industry cannot be just shut down in one day or in one year and cannot be changed upside down just like that. We have to find a way to do a smooth transition. Make current facilities greener will be for sure the realistic way. In the previous slide, we have seen that plastic demand will do nothing but increase. The use of planes, cars, trains will do the same. Introducing changes on the way we produce combustible and plastics will be one important brick on the wall that will slow down and stop the global warming. This presentation will cover the following aspects. First, where can we find the opportunities to undertake any change? Second, when we think about typical production sites such as oil refineries and polymer production plants, the approach may be different depending on the type of projects. Later, we will review some particularities of the upstream and offshore facilities. To end, I want to show you some real cases where integration has shown its viability. When we think green, we think on reducing CO2 emissions. Then the picture of a solar panel or a windmill comes to our minds. That means we only think on electric production. In oil and gas or petrochemical plants, there is a huge demand of heat and coal that has to be considered too. Also, we need to think that these industrial facilities are not only the process plant itself, the main process, but there are also buildings required for the plant operation, control buildings, hospitals, workshops, administration buildings, and many others. This represents also an opportunity to reduce the power consumption and minimize the CO2 emissions. The heat and material balance of the facility is the main starting point to identify the demands of hot and heat and refrigeration. This balance will also help to discover where there could be a waste of thermal energy. Every joule generated without CO2 emissions will count to our target. This target is to make the facility greener, but also we have to keep in mind that the production has to remain within the safety. Therefore, Any technology considered needs to be reliable, and the integration must be done in a way that normal functionality of the plant does not change. Brownfield means existing plant. This type of projects consist on works to improve the operability of a live plant or to increase its production. The heat and material balance and the analysis of the power demands are mandatory. You have to keep in mind that integration is complicated, but possible. First approach is to identify the technologies that can be replaced. For example, big compressors and pumps moved by electrical motors can be replaced by more efficient machines, reducing the consumption balance in power and then CO2 emissions. Also, in the plant, the type of batteries used can be changed from liquid acid to solid systems, less aggressive to the environment. Fuel steam used Fuel or natural gas used on steam boilers can be replaced by biomass, also as an option to make the facility greener. And finally, it's a good approach to identify where solar photovoltaic can be introduced at a large scale, for example, rooftops and parking lots. There are many possibilities. Brownfield projects are a good example for the approach of considering several options at the same time. As we said at the very beginning, we are not going to be able to replace every source of energy in an existing plant by a single source of energy coming from the sun or the wind. Other options we can consider is, for example, to improve the performance of the waste treatment facilities by introducing the capacity to produce biogas from the waste. This biogas can be either used inside the facilities to produce electricity or can be exported. This is a nice example of how one of the big oil majors is already considered to use solar power to reduce the consumption of energy coming from external sources, so making Singapore refinery a little bit greener. In opposite to brownfield, greenfield means new plant. For this type of projects, we are allowed to implement the use of renewable energies in the basic design. This will reduce the investment cost and the risk of a complicated integration in an operating plant. This will prevent from complicated modifications. Requirements for low emission technologies can be incorporated on the project specification and the design basis. Sometimes, just a few adjustments on the design criteria and the project specification can lead us to build a plant, a greener plant with less emissions. For example, review the requirements for future expansions, being realistic on the market evolution that will lead to consider less overdesign on the equipment. This means during operation, the efficiency factor of that equipment will be better and the emissions and power consumption will be less. Also, on the material supply for the construction of the plant, we can not only consider the price, but consider the emissions on the whole life of that material. One of the renewable technologies that can be used during a greenfield project is the CSP, the concentrated solar power. It's hard to implement this kind of technology on a brownfield project because of the need of space and the amount of changes we have to do on the existing plant to rich and adequate integration. However, can be considered as an option on the greenfield projects, not only for power generation, but mainly for steam and hot water production. Also, in polymer industry, the need of having a source of heat, which is the hot oil, can be also considered as a point to introduce the CSP. If we have done an adequate, appropriate heat and material balance, we will identify several streams that has to be cooled down, where refrigeration is required to reduce temperature. That means power consumption for air coolers or other source of cold. Why not using these streams, having excess of heat in an absorption machine to produce refrigeration or other services? The main advantage of renewable energy is the need of space to produce a kilowatt or a joule in comparison with fossil fuels. The location of upstream and offshore facilities in not occupied areas implies that we have a huge amount of free space. Also, the remote location of these facilities make them suitable to operate disconnected from the power grid. That means we will reduce the cost, for example, of electrical cables and power supply networks. And coming to an end, before finishing, I want to show you and to introduce you three cases of success about integration of this approach we have seen in the previous slides. The first case is the Saki project. The second case is the study of the Glass Point Company. And the third case is the project executed by the combination of the Australian government and the Arena Company. The Saki project will show us how to take advantage of a huge amount of thermal energy available and wasted. Liquefied natural gas storage has to be vaporized before exported to the grid and to the natural gas network in a city or within a country. That means there is a huge waste of energy in terms of refrigeration and cold. These facilities has been incorporated a kind of system that will take advantage of that refrigeration power to export that cold to the surrounding facilities, reducing the cost and the power consumption of that facilities and industries. This approach, of course, can be considered not only for brownfield project, which is the case, but also for any new regasification facility we can face and we can design. The second example is the case of Glass Point. This company uses the CSP concentrated solar power to produce the steam required on oil extraction operation. This, of course, reduces the fossil fuel consumption. In this configuration we see on the slide, they are using a conventional boiler during the night, and for that they require the use of fuel gas. This configuration could be made greener if we use the storage of thermal energy. Of course, for that we will require more space and more investment on the solar field. As you see in this picture, we can see what we talk about when we speak and we say that green energy requires a huge amount of space. That's the reason upstream and offshore projects can be a good opportunity to proceed with integration. The last case, the third example, is the oil beam pumps to solar project. Again, this is an upstream project and also in a brownfield configuration because the oil pumps were already there. This is a very simple example of using the available space to cut the needs of external power source and reduce operational cost by installing a solar generation field. Before ending this presentation, I want to recall your attention to one fact, to one point. Oil and gas and petrochemical is a huge consumer of power, heat and refrigeration. That means, for sure, there will be a lot of opportunities to reduce the power consumption and to integrate renewable energies to reduce CO2 emissions. Be creative. Keep in mind this all the time. Just to end, maybe a lot of you have been thinking about that, but personally, I do not rely on carbon dioxide capture approach. For me, this is not a solution. This is just a way to postpone the problem. Thank you very much, and I hope we can meet in the future in an integration project like the ones we have seen today. Thank you.